Are you ready to make the jump from watching videos to uploading videos? Well, if you are, then stick around because I'm about to show you step by step how to upload your first video to YouTube.
Deliver your value.
Hi, and welcome to Creator Fundamentals. My name is Dan Currier, and I am here to help you deliver your value through online video. So it's super exciting that you have decided to get involved to become a YouTuber. In this video, I'm gonna show you exactly what you need to do to get that first video up so everybody can check it out here on YouTube. And hey, this is a great start to get you on your way. Also, make sure you click that subscribe button and the bell notification icon to receive alerts on future videos that can help you deliver your value. All right, let's jump over onto the computer and we'll walk through the process of what you have to do to upload your first video. And hey, this video is sponsored by TubeBuddy. TubeBuddy is the number one browser plugin for managing and growing your YouTube channel. It's available to download for free and there's a link in the description below. All right, so we're here on the computer. Let's get started. For the purpose of this particular tutorial, we are going to assume that you A, have a Google account, and B, you are currently signed in to that Google account. As you can see here, when you go to YouTube, you will be required to sign in. If you're signed into Google, it'll just automatically associate with that particular account. I just made up a Gmail account here for the purpose of this tutorial. So in this case today, we're going to be Joe the YouTuber, and we want to upload our first video. So we are logged in. This is the home page that we're looking at here. So where do we go? Well, for one thing, you can't. There's a couple different ways, but just to get a sense of what YouTube, how it's arranged, click on the round icon and then click on My Channel. All right, so when you first try to go to your channel, obviously you don't have one because you haven't created one yet, so it's going to ask you exactly what you want to use to YouTube as. In this case, we're going to do the best tuber ever. Click Create Channel. And typically, this is the screen that appears when something goes wrong. And as you can see, when you hover over it, it says something went wrong. So what's going on, YouTube? Do you not like our channel? Just to make sure, we're going to click on YouTube, go back to the main screen, and then we are going to try to go to our channel and make sure that it was created. All right, so in this case, the channel was created. YouTube's just being weird. So if you do encounter that issue and it looks like the channel was not created, go ahead and click refresh or click the YouTube icon and then actually go to your channel. So in this case, we're on a channel that has absolutely no content. If you click on YouTube Studio Beta, that's gonna bring you to the behind the scenes on your channel. And it gives you kind of a little run through about what's going on. Got it, and look at that. Easy peasy. The very first video that you go to upload with the new, this is the new interface for YouTube behind the scenes, which is called YouTube Studio. And look, they're actually prompting you straightforward. Instead of going through the traditional method of uploading a video, they're actually giving you this link right here to get started and upload your video. So we're gonna go ahead and click that and see what that looks like. All right, so this is the traditional page that you see when you go to upload a video on YouTube. So what we want to do, the very first thing that I highly recommend that you do is right here where it says public, you want to set that to unlisted because you don't want to upload your video and just have it go immediately public because there's some stuff that you want to add to your video to make sure that it is seen by other people and that people know what it's about, title and description and stuff like that. So that's what we're going to list it as, which is unlisted up until the point where we have an opportunity to kind of add some additional information to it. From this point, we just need to select a video and actually upload it by dragging it over this particular window. One thing I want to throw at you guys here, if you are just getting started and you're just uploading videos and you've chosen to upload videos on your phone, you can actually also upload from your phone as well. And we'll get into that here in just a moment. But one of the things you can also do is you can download Google Drive. Google Drive gives you free storage that would allow you to basically download the Google Drive app to your phone. And after you've made a video with the phone, you can drop it into Google Drive and then open Google Drive on your home computer and actually grab that file and upload through the desktop interface. So in this case, I've just created a quick video that I'm gonna put in my Google Drive, and then we're gonna go grab it and check it out and actually use it to upload. All right, so in this case, we're gonna hop over to Google Drive, find the video that we transferred from the phone, and actually going to double click on that and download it. And now we have the YouTube window in the background and we have our first video here. You can actually just click on the video and drag it over.
And that is going to do a couple different things. First, of course, it's going to start uploading it. It also gives you an interface to add some information about your video so people know exactly what is going on here. And as you can see, we've defaulted it to unlisted. And if we scroll down, it's currently working on analyzing the video to come up with a couple thumbnails for that. So one of the things that you'll get as you become more comfortable in uploading videos, the idea of a custom thumbnail, which means instead of letting them just take a screenshot from your video to display to people when your video is listed next to others on the platform, you can actually upload something that's custom, like a design that you create that kind of gives a little more information or is a little more visual in terms of what your video is about. But we'll certainly cover that in a future video, or I'll put a link to a custom thumbnail video at the end of this tutorial so you guys can check that out if you are looking to see how that process works and what you use to actually create a custom thumbnail. All right, so what happens is it goes through the upload process and then it has to process the video. Usually happens pretty fast, but it can vary depending on the length of the video, etc. So we'll see here it's at 95%. And we'll wait till that gets all the way through. But in this case, we have your title here. This is going to show people exactly what your video is about. You want to create a title that interests people and gives some insight into what it is that you're making your content about. And then, in this video, I talk about, just to describe exactly what your video is about. This stuff is going to become more important as you continue to become consistent on the platform and upload videos. For now, with your first upload, I think it's just super important that you focus on getting comfortable with the process, making content, getting more comfortable in front of the camera. And then as you progress, there's a bunch of other cool tips, tricks, and techniques that you guys can learn to grow and build your channel and get noticed on YouTube. Now, depending on your particular topic, obviously the information that you put in these fields, which is frequently referred to as SEO, which stands for search engine optimization, or it's sometimes called metadata. Metadata just means data about data. So in this case, it's information about your video. That's why they call it metadata. But as you have a specific topic for your video, you will look for things like specific keywords that you want to use that help people identify your content. I have a bunch of content on Creative Fundamentals about how to use keyword research to help people see your videos. So definitely check out those videos. I'll throw a couple links in the description below if you want to learn more about that. But for now, just to get your first video uploaded, in this video, I talk about this being my first video. Obviously, the information that you put on your first video is going to be much more specific to what you're doing here. Now, the other thing is you want to get in the habit of is creating playlists. In this case, there are no playlists. This is a brand new channel. But I'm going to create a playlist. We'll say these are my personal vlogs. Depending on the type of content that you're doing, you kind of want to create categories within your channel for the types of videos so you can group them together and present them to people in a meaningful way. That's going to help them decide whether or not they want to see more of your content. So in this case, we're going to do personal vlogs. Here we go. And remember, we put everything as unlisted so you can get all this information put in before anybody sees the video. So now, as you can see on the bottom, we have those thumbnail screen prints. We're just going to select one of those by default. We'll cover custom thumbnails in a future tutorial. But this is basically what the interface it looks like. You obviously get all this information filled in. We have your translations tab. You really don't have to worry too much about this in the beginning unless you are bilingual or you have somebody that is that can actually create a translation in a different language for the information. But for the purpose of your first video, I'd say you can skip translations for now. Advanced settings, categories can be helpful. You can determine what type of content that you're making. You got people and vlogs. If you're doing a vlog style, you can leave it like that. You can set your default language, which is in my case English. And then you have some other options here. Allow comments, usually leave that default. You want this set to standard YouTube license and not Creative Commons. One of the things I see a lot of people do is get this somehow set to Creative Commons, and that basically indicates that it's okay for other people to use your content. So For now, I think standard YouTube license is the way you want to keep that. And most of the other information in here, you don't really need to mess with, especially on your first video. So we're kind of cool with that. We're going to click, go back to basic information there and click done. Now you see that we have the option to return to editing and then we have a link. But remember, we left this video as unlisted. So what I'm going to show you now is how you actually go in and set the video to be public so people can actually see it. All right, so if we click on my first video, it's going to bring you to the unlisted view of that video. And then you'll see this is what people are going to see when that video goes live. So we have the obviously the standard video view. You have the channel there with your description. This is all the information that's going to be presented to them and then comments as people leave them. Now from here, we can go into edit video. And this is kind of the how I go still to this day, how I create a video. Now, YouTube is kind of in a transitional space right now with the YouTube Studio, which is this new interface, which is how we started this. But there's also the option to go back to YouTube Creator Studio. And until they actually get all of the features on the YouTube Studio, you may have to go back to the Creator Studio and upload or update some things. But one of the things you can do on here that's not really present in the other one is the idea of end screens, where you can actually put videos and things here at the end of your video to send people to other videos that you have. Now, you're not going to be able to do this right now because this is your first video, which is awesome. But as you have multiple videos, then you can come in here and you can set these things to these cards to send people to your like most recent videos. In this case, because there aren't any uploads, it's not going to let you do that because it's not going to send you back to the video that you're watching. So other stuff you can get into in future videos. But here we're just trying to get this uploaded and ready to go. So here's what we do. We got all our information there. We have our thumbnail picked. Don't need to worry about enhancements or audio or anything like that. We just want to get this bad boy public. So here we go. We set it to public. And we have it set to our personal vlogs playlist. Now you're seeing some extra stuff on here, vidIQ and TubeBuddy. These are all add-ins and plugins that can help you with some tools, but we're going to ignore all that for now. We just care about the basics here. And normally you'd have a lot more keywords than what you're seeing here. But we got that. We set it to public and we click publish. Now when we go to that video, you'll see that the video is now live. People can interact with it. They can give it a thumbs up. They can say, cool video. They can do anything they want. And people are able to find your video out on the platform. And that is all there is to it. Congratulations, you've uploaded your first video to YouTube. Now, if you want to upload your video directly to YouTube from your phone, stay tuned because we're going to cover that real quick. I'll show you exactly how that process works and what you need to do. All right, so here on mobile, in the upper right-hand corner, there's a little icon, looks like a camera. Go ahead and click on that. You're going to allow access to the camera and select your video. It gives you the opportunity to edit the video if you want to trim it a little bit. And then once you're ready, you click on the next button in the upper right-hand corner. You notice a theme there. A lot of the controls are upper right-hand corner. But go ahead, click the next. Here it brings you to the screen to add your title and description. Now, what I recommend here is to upload, or while you're uploading your video via mobile, to actually upload it as unlisted like we did on the desktop version. So we're going to go ahead and add the title and the description, get that all filled out. And after we're done there, we're going to head into that privacy section where it says public, and we're going to go ahead and change that to unlisted. So we get our description filled out however we want to. Again, this is just an example. You want your description to be a little more thorough than what I'm doing here. And then once you do that, go in and set it to unlisted and click that upload button. Now it's going to go in, you're going to show the set, see the status of it uploading, and then it's going to go ahead and process it. You don't want to navigate away from this screen, or you just want to make sure that your phone can handle it if you do, because a lot of times if you do that, it won't actually upload. From this point, you can see now that that video is uploaded and unlisted. All right, so once we're uploaded, we're going to transition over to the YouTube Studio app. We're going to click on that unlisted video, and then we can go into it, set up a playlist, make sure this is added to that playlist, and add tags and any additional information we want prior to actually making it public. In this case, I'm just doing a single tag as an example of how they work. You basically type in your tag and then hit the return key, and that's going to take that keyword phrase and save it as a tag. So once you have all that done, you're good to go. If you wanted to upload a custom thumbnail, this is where you would do it. And then you click privacy, set it to public, and then click the save button, and your video is live. And in case you're curious, the little box with the gear in it provides you with some additional options, but typically you don't have to touch those when uploading a video. And we click save, and bam, your video is live on YouTube straight from your mobile device.
I hope you found this video helpful. Let me know in the comments below. And if you have any follow-up questions, I'll be sure to answer them down there as well. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Dan Currier, and you're watching Creator Fundamentals. Thank you.